Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, and welcome back to the Chosokabe campaign for Total War Shogun 2. The assault will begin in this part. This is part 12 of the campaign, and I think the first 10 episodes of this campaign were probably the kind of prelude. They were the whole kind of capturing the Shikoku part of Japan, all of this island, and making sure it's under our control. And I think part kind of 11 to part 20 will be me trying to take over all of this land here. I think we're going to have plenty and plenty of battles to play. And I think I've picked perhaps the best point to attack this island, as they have a full stack, or they did have a full stack army here. I think they've perhaps split their forces. Oh, nope, there's the full stack here in the south. And we are going to struggle, I think. We have four units. They are slightly depleted, especially the cavalry. They are good units, so they have lots of experience. And Hyuga is there for the take-in. So we're going to try and take Hyuga in this part. And then, of course, we'll fend off this army. We'll try and hold Hyuga for as long as possible. If we do lose it, we will try and take out as many units as we can, because we do have a secondary ship over here with my daimyo, Chosokabe Kunichika. He's courageous, but he is distrustful. And then, of course, we have the great man himself, Chosokabe Masayo. Strategist, cavalry commander, infantry leader. He's devoted, he's brave, and he has a favourite mount, so he's got a +1 charge bonus, and he's got a +10% effectiveness of the rally ability. So he's a great general to have in your army. And this ship is actually going to make its way now across to that island. Now, we do have to tread carefully, because we are, of course, only on bow kabayas, and if I do happen to lose a naval battle, I lose all of this army, and I'll just be wasted completely. So I need to be careful with the navy. I have my general here, and we have some units remaining, not many. We could take him out with a general, perhaps. We do actually have some bow units available to me. I'm thinking about it. Probably would be the best. We don't have anything recruited, I don't think. No, we don't. Get the bow units out in that case. Join them up with the general. Suicidal, maybe? I don't know. Two against five. The bows would definitely crumble. It can be done. Let's attack them here first. Oh yes, this can be done, definitely. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, I think. We have more experience. They may have more men. I like the sound of this. Let's fight this battle. Let's go in. 81 against 361. Let's fight them. Let's get an early battle in this video, in this skirmish. Emura Makoto versus Yasuda Nahozane. Battle of Our Fields, 1553. I don't like the look of this battlefield, though. This kind of terrain, it could be very, very bad for me. I have a plan for this battle. It involves heavy skirmishing and using my cavalry to great effect. Basically, pull away from the bows with the cav, try and split them, get my bows to engage their infantry, and get my cavalry to engage their bows. It's going to take an awful lot of micromanagement, so I do need to be very careful indeed in this battle. And here we go, dry weather. That should be fine, I think. Okay, so we're going to start the battle straight away. They're down there, so in that case, let's march straight up. This is actually perfect. The hill is what I need. They're going to have their bows in the front. All three are in the front. What I need to do is give them a target to aim at. Now, I'm looking at this battlefield. I think perhaps, actually, this is perfect. We can actually go for this Yari Ashigara unit, because it's a general unit. My bows are going to engage them, while my cavalry, it's going to go for the charge straight away. I'm going to go for the charge, but I'm going to veer out of this charge straight away. Firing on a moving unit is difficult. Whoa, they've stopped. What the hell? Get out of there. Glitch. Bullshit alert. That shouldn't have happened. Have we taken losses? Oh shit, we took two losses. That's terrible. I definitely clicked then as well. That's terrible. Let's get out of there. My bows are firing anyway, and it's distracted them enough, so it's not total It's not totally detrimental to losing this battle. We've pulled Yari Ashigaru away. We're still focused on the general, and they have taken some losses. This could actually work in our favour if we are careful. I don't mind getting them chasing me all over the battlefield. But I don't like to be split away from my other unit, so I need to be careful. And I'm not losing nearly enough Yari Ashigarus. We need them to lose a lot more than this. Right. There's bows there. Oh, there's plenty of bows. Go for that charge now. Get in there, my boy. Get in there. We'll get a rallying cry now when we get up this hill. We must charge. Rally. Have to charge them. Oh, yes. Get in there. Engage them all. That's what I wanted. Nice clean charge on all three. Gotta get up there quickly because the Yari Ashigarus will be upon me any moment now. Inspire. I'm going to have to disengage, I'm afraid. That's fine. We've done the damage. Or as much damage as we can possibly muster in this part of the battlefield. Just drag ourselves out. We stop them from firing for a moment. And this unit is steady, but it's charging up. Let's continue to fire up here. Get them to chase me. Forty-six remaining. Let's get fire arrows going. Come on, guys, get a good fire away. Oh, point blank range, that's good. And they are shaken now. Shaken but not stirred. Get them to stir, boys. Okay, let's chase this guy here. That's too close. Right. Get the general back. Bows are exposed, all in the rear. Let's get the general down the flank. Two Yari Ashigarus are chasing the bows, which is what I want. I gotta hope that they don't rout my men now. Get the bows to charge. Gotta take out these bows quickly. Don't let them get shots on me. No. Engage them. Straight through for the second unit. Get them out there quickly. Straight through for the third. I have to do this. I have to spread them. This is good. Routed two of them. Keep going. Micromanaging like a bitch right now. Let's get my men down there towards the end of the battlefield. Right, we've engaged them all now. They're shaking as well. That's good. It's working so far. The infantry is going to cause problems for me, I think. Let's just get onto the plains now. I got 14 cavalrymen remaining, and my general's still alive. We've killed them all. Good. Now, there, Yari Ashigaru is wavering. And they're gone. There we go. Victory. It worked. Two units against five, and we won. Excellent. Continue the battle, of course. We want to kill them all. My bows can fire upon this unit and get as many kills as they can to get that experience up, while my general is going to chase down the remaining unit over here. Let's fast forward this. Nice to start the video off with a good win. Outnumbered. But the rebellion is over. And our town now should be fine. There we go. Let's get as many kills as we can. And they're going to get over that line by the looks of it. Doing a pretty good job though. We leveled up, I think. I think we've leveled up. There we go. Heroic victory, of course. Was always going to be heroic, that was. And now we have to start thinking about the best way to get my men over to that island to start the assault. At the moment, I've only got four units over there, so it's going to be a bit tricky. So I only lost 21 out of 81, and they lost most of their men. Unfortunately, they're still on the campaign map, but that will be done and dusted now once I get my, if I do his old trick by here, click the general, he has more movement points, send him onto him. And of course this is an auto resolve, this one is, so we just auto resolve this and we would probably take no losses or minimal losses. Didn't take any, so we won that battle. And there we go. Victory. Get my general back into this guy. And then my public order is zero because we've sorted that rebellion out. So this town won't revolt against me now. We do need to repair the improved irrigation. So we will have to do that when we get more money. But our money should probably go back to normal before long. Sanuki is fine. They are exempt, of course. We need to unexempt them to get more cash. I'm not going to do that quite yet. I'm going to wait probably a turn or two. Mike probably could raise the or lower the tax. If I lower the tax to normal and then do it, they're okay then. Yeah, we could do that. Io is exempt as well. We unexempt them. And then the only one that's left is Awadri, which would revolt, but I would be getting profit of 141 koku. It's probably worth it for that. This general can go towards Awadri in that case. Kitabatake, let's have a look at them, see where they are. Have I met them yet? I haven't met the Kitabatake yet. I can't really do anything. The Shoni I'm allied with, which was an important thing to do because they're in the north of this island, and I wanted to get an ally nearby. And the Ito are only at war with me, so I'm not upsetting any rivals. So I'm going to try and go southwards, I think, with this navy. I'm going to try actually recruit. Well, I can't afford this turn, but next turn I can afford to recruit some more ships to join. So we're going to actually sail halfway to scout ahead, not sail too close. It's important that I don't lose this army, this navy. Right, we're okay. There's no enemies nearby, so we can actually drag that around. It's going to take me a good 2 to 3 turns, so I need to try and hold Hyuga if I take it. So I could actually attack the big army with a 4, but I won't win that battle. So we're going to go for Hyuga and take it. And we are actually, or we were blockading the both ports. This port is still alive, but we are costing them a lot of money. These two naval ships can actually go around. Just double check what they have. Yeah, we can actually take these two naval ships to attack them at Satsuma. And then this ship here, or this army here, sorry, can attack Hyuga. That is what we're going to do. We're going to attack Hyuga. As you can see, Ito Chikahira, the enemy commander, and plus a samurai retainer and a Yari Ashigaru garrison. That's what we're fighting. Let's fight this battle as well. Battle of Saito, 1553. Kuwana Kajetsuga versus Ito Chikahira. And I have a plan in place for assaulting them in this battle, of course. I have bows. I'm going to try and use all their ammunition before I get into the settlement. If they have towers, I'm going to try and avoid the towers and take as few losses as I can before I get all my men up there and Yari wall them to death. That is the plan for my assault. It's a pretty basic strategy, really. I actually have a basic strategy for defense and a basic strategy for attack. My defense strategy is to lure the men into the fort, into the palisade, get them to climb the walls, Yari wall, and then basically when they climb the walls, they're already taking losses. But in a siege defense, you don't actually lose morale. Right, we'll start dry. We've got bows. Yes, and as expected, they have towers. So where are they? Here and there. So this would be the best point to attack, I think. That's the tower. That's the tower. They are pretty wide. So yeah, this would be the best point to attack. We're actually only going to bring the bows from this part of the battlefield. They don't have any bows, so we can march with confidence. I'm keeping the rest of my troops here. The AI may fix upon them. They have a Yari Ashigaru garrison. I need to weaken that garrison. And they have their general, of course, which we must take out. I don't want to burn the gate. The reason being, if I am in a siege defense in the next part, I actually want to keep the gates so that the enemy has to climb the walls. If the gates are wide open, they'll try and go through. They won't lose men to the walls. That's my thinking there. Let's fast forward this a little bit. And for some reason, our morale's pretty shaken. So we may have to wait a few moments. We're actually going to do that. We're going to fast forward this battle to get the morale back up. It's on red at the moment. Right, we'll try it on play now. Might be best to bring my unit slightly closer. Try and get that encouragement going. I'm just doing this bit by bit, because basically the AI has certain set patterns in the way it walks around the fort. For example, this one right now is walking, and it'll probably end up roughly where I am, so all I have to do is bring it forward slightly and leave them there. And then whenever a unit is there, like now, my unit will actually start firing. So we're actually going to get some kills on the retainers. There we go, killed three of them. And they'll stay there for a few moments. I'm actually going to turn fire at will off. Keep it on for when they're attacking them like they are right now. But once they start moving, I'll turn it off straight away. There we go. Turn it off. Got lots of kills there. That's good. And we're not taking losses to the towers, which is also important. So we're going to creep forward again. Just creep forward, because that way we know when we're in range of the towers when they start firing. There we go. And again, we can start bringing our troops forward slightly. We're nowhere near the range of the towers, so we can actually go a bit closer. About there. The tower range would only be sort of a few meters outside the actual walls of the settlement, so we should be okay. And as you can see, our morale has gone up now. Oops. Wrong button there, let's click these. Drag them forward a little bit more. Into position. And as you can see, more men now for us to kill. So we'll wait until they stop. There we go, they're lining up now. So we'll turn fire at will back on. Because they're in a stable position, they're not moving. Which means they're in a good position to take losses. They've lost five men in that first volley. Another five men. Six men, actually. And we'll just keep doing this now until they keep losing men. The less men I have to fight in this battle, the better. Even though I have very strong units, I want to keep them alive for the follow-up battle. There we go, turn fire at will off now. Okay, they moved. As you can see, a couple of them are dying there. He doesn't look too good. And we have another victim. Samurai retainers again. So once they stop moving, which they are right now, we can toggle fire at will back on. They're in a good position for us to take some more kills on them. Inflict damage upon them. There we go. Unfortunately, they are the right side of the wall, so the arrows are going into the wall rather than up and over. A different angle would have probably been better for me. But as you can see, we haven't lost... We haven't used up too much percentage of the arrows. Probably 20%. And this unit is already down 1/3 of its unit, so that's very good. There we go again, another kill, so we turn that off now. Nope, a few arrows missed. See, this is why you gotta turn it off, because those arrows will most likely miss. Let's see. Well, we got two kills, that's not too bad. We can actually turn it back on, they've stopped again. That's actually a better position for me to attack. More room to inflict more damage, so let's see what happens now. See, they got over the wall this time. 40 men down to 34. Much better volley. Hopefully we can get another volley in. Here we go, another volley. 34 men down to 28. Much, much better that was. One more volley again. 28 men down to 23. And in three volleys, we've actually reduced them to under half. And there we go, turn that off now. 22 men remaining. They're not going to cause us too much problem. Let's focus on the general this time. We're actually going to click on the general now that he's in position. Let's weaken the general. Reduce the morale. Where is he? There he is. There's the general. Oh, I'm going to turn that off now. Actually, halt it on too because it was an attack order. Okay, so that worked out reasonably well. We still have lots and lots of ammunition to go. But I am actually going to start thinking about where I'm going to place my men. So what I'm going to do is drag my bow units a little bit further. Not too much further because I don't want to be shot. But just to cover a bit more of the fort. Like so. We're still not getting attacked by them, so we can go a bit further forward. Just test out to see when I'm in range. And we're actually going to turn on fire at will, so I am going to worry about that. I know whenever they walk there, they're going to get shot. Now, my cavalry isn't going to be any use unless I capture the gate. So what I'm going to do is take my cavalry over to here, and then over to here, like so. To issue an attack movement order like that, you click. But while you click for the first movement, you hold down the left shift button and then click a second time. So it's one movement there and then a second movement there. And now we need to work on the walls. Where are we going to hit them and where would be best? So we've got two towers to watch out for. My bows are still doing damage, as you can see. The general's down to 35. Now he's down to 32. That's excellent. So he's down 1/4. He's only got 3/4 remaining, 3/4. And I got two units of Yari Ashgaru. Now the problem is with siege attacking is our morale is terrible and their morale will constantly stay up. They will not rout. That's why it's important. You've got to kill them to the very last man. That's why whenever you're defending a siege, it's much easier in Shogun 2 than it is attacking. That goes for pretty much every total war. Always much easier in a defense than it is an attack. So, I think what I'm going to do, this one is stronger but has less men. They're going to actually march there. Click the R button so they only march. And this one is going to actually come to here. And again, I think we're going to go for this part of the wall because it's smaller. And it's also near the gate so the general can get in quicker. And we're going to go from this side then to this wall and this gate. So we have two gates and two walls. And in the meantime, we're going to focus on our bows. They are doing damage, I believe. Yes, down to 19. That's great. Let's click on the general. I want to get some kills on the general. And we're going to put flaming arrows back on. Because why not? So here we go. Flaming arrows up and over the wall. The palisade. Hopefully we get some good kills. Not so good, really. 25 remaining. That wasn't the best of volleys. Oh no, that's terrible. Keep fire at will on so we can get some more kills. They are actually bringing the Yari Ashigaru back towards me. If I had more than one bow unit, I could probably win this battle without actually coming into the settlement. Believe it or not. There we go, the bows are firing now. Up and over the wall. Again. Kills, lots of kills. Excellent. 13 retainers remaining. See, this whole unit could be taken out by just my bows. They actually may be, that may actually happen in this battle. They are wavering, but they won't rout because they're inside the settlement. If they were outside the walls, they'd be gone already. They would have routed. That's how the morale system works in this game. Towers aren't attacking me yet. I would love it if the general came out and attacked me. That can sometimes happen in siege defences. I think recently the game had a minor update and that actually does happen now. The general can sometimes surge out if he thinks that there's a target nearby that he can attack. Which would work in my favour because I got Yari Ashigaru, which are very good against general unit. Right. Let's just stay where we are and keep it in fire at will. And it's time now that we started the assault. So we're actually going to attack from here with this unit. We're going to walk up slowly and we're actually going to attack from here. And again, we're going to walk up while my general is going to be this side waiting, ready to attack them. That was a terrible, terrible volley. Quarter of the Yari Ashigaru were gone as well. Got some more kills. Now, once I've used up all the ammunition from my bow Ashigaru, what I'm going to do is actually use them as an additional unit of infantry. It's got three levels of experience, and if you look at the right-hand side of the screen, you'll see that my stats have been boosted. And if you look at the morale attack for the Yari Ashigaru is a 6, it's actually the same with these. It's a 6. Defense is a 6. Defense is a 5. Not too bad. Charge bonus of a 5. So it does kind of stack up. So they aren't going to be totally useless in a battle, basically. Now their towers will start firing soon. And the thing is, my cavalry could easily take out the retainers and their general. So I only have to worry about their Yari Ashigaru. This is a standard garrison, which has no experience, as you can see on the banner. Whereas mine have 2 and 3 respectively, so it should be a relatively easy, straightforward fight. But the problem I'm fighting at the moment is the actual morale system. I'm going to actually bring my troops, my bow units, a little bit closer. We've started the assault now with this unit here. Once I take this, the cavalry's going to be straight in to back them up. And hopefully we can win this battle. We should win this battle. The only way I can see myself losing this battle right now is if the morale kind of screws us over, because they all are, they're all on red basically. As you can see, they are attacking me now as well, so I'm going to have to be very careful indeed. Here we go, of Yari. What sort of Yari walling myself right now? We're going to try to at least. We are routing the retainers, or they're wavering anyway. We need to be extremely fast here, extremely fast. Hurry up, dudes. We have to attack the cavalry. Hope we get enough men up to take out the cavalry. These guys have used up all their ammo, so I need to get up there as well. For some reason, my clicks are not registering quick enough. There we go. They're up now. And we are doing relatively well against the general. As you can see, they're down to 12 units. They are losing, of course. I am losing lots of men as well. But this is fine. We've got them pinned up in the corner. We can take out the general. Down to 10. We should easily take out the general. We are taking losses, of course, but that's fine. Once we start taking the middle of this, we'll start taking the towers as well, if we need to. I don't think we'll have to, though. We are getting into a very tight sort of Yari wall, and we are getting some men. Oh, it looks like some men have glitched out, unfortunately. They have Yari walled down at the bottom rather than climb to the top. But that's okay. We've got our bow units in support. As you can see, some of them are falling. We are losing some of them. But they can be enough to relieve them, probably.
Our men are running from the battlefield.
Oh, my God. This is glitching for me. Why is it glitching? The bullshit is too much. No. This is terrible. This is better. We're going to Yari wall. I just hope that we can win now. We're Yari walling, so we should be okay. We'd hope. They just ran into a Yari wall, and we are more experienced. As you can see, our morale's just gone straight up. Oh, it's gone back down. That's not good. And my bow units can cause damage. My bow units are doing well. Pity I can't get my general in. I needed to take that quicker. I didn't take it quick enough. I may need to bring him in. I don't want to do this, though. Bring him out.
Our men are running from the battlefield. Shame for this plan.
Shit. This isn't going to plan. We're going to lose this one, I'm afraid. Yes, we're going to lose this. Unfortunately, now this is a good demonstration of the morale system. I basically couldn't touch them. They are routing. They have 35 and 1 remaining, plus 5 there, yet I can't get in there. However, I see a chance for an opportunity. Oh, damn. No, I don't. Can't get in there. It looks like I will have to burn down this gate, I'm afraid. Those Chosokabe, Bow Ashigaru are not going to come back to me. The same with the Yari Ashigaru, I'm afraid. I still have a full unit which hasn't lost taken any losses yet, and they are fresh. But I'm gonna have to burn down the gates. I'm gonna have to dismount. I didn't want to dismount. I didn't want to burn down the gates because it gives them a great opportunity in the follow-up battle. But it has to be done. I have to burn the gates down and get back on the horse. Hopefully I got enough time to do this and not take any losses. There still is a slither of hope that I win this. The balance of power is extremely in my favour. I got a high level general. He's not a general, he's a light cav, but you get the point. It would be great if they came out, which they might do actually. Nope, general's not going to come out, that's a shame. There we go, excellent. Let's mount back on. Let's get back on our horses. There's actually a way into the settlement now. Perfect. Here we go, guys. Make sure they're all back on. They appear to be. Let's go for it. And we can do this. It's still possible. Just gotta remain calm and hope that we don't get screwed over by bullshit, basically. Here we go, straight in, straight for the kill. Gonna go for the general straight away. Charge down their general. It's only five of their unit remaining. We're taking some losses to the arrow tower. That's fine though. Boom, there we go. One remaining. Their general's gone. Now for the retainers and the Yari Ashigaru units. Look at this, 33 and 1. All we got left is the Yari Ashigaru. Unfortunately, I can't take the arrow towers if I'm not dismounted, so I'm going to have to keep fighting like this. Scout here. Oh my god, 9 horses remain. Oh, look at that. 26 men remaining and we lost. Damn. That just goes to show you how deadly it is in these siege attacks. So we actually lost this battle, but we have weakened the settlement. Unfortunately, we haven't got an army nearby to follow this battle up, because we've got to get our army, our main army, from the ships. But it was worth a try. We still have 2 units remaining, which is good. There we go. We can't actually attack them this turn though, because we used up our movement points. So I'm going to click end turn. And we're going to see what happens in the end turn phase. And then I'm probably going to end this episode there. So we had 2 good battles, 1 win, 1 loss. And we are getting nearer to our assault. So there we go. As expected, we have this large army that's attacking us. And we're not going to win this battle. But I'm actually going to save this here. If it'll let me. I don't think it will let me, actually. You can't save for a battle. Of course, it's automatic save. Okay, so we're going to pick the next video up from this part in the campaign. I've been Dragonheart. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye.